Durant cet après-midi, nous allons
This
ensemble
afternoon, we're going to be together
le thème de l'année.
to go deeper into the theme of the year for our
Donc, nous allons
pilgrimages.
entendre dans
So you're going to hear in a couple of moments
qui va venir
from
dans quelques
Father
instants.
Brito.
Et puis, dans la deuxième partie
And then in
d'après-midi,
the second part of the
il y a
afternoon,
une proposition
there's
liée directement à l'organisation de votre pèlerinage en tant que pèlerin.
Suggestion to be able to prepare for your pilgrimage with the planning team. You'll have seen there's a planning meeting which will happen at the information center in various different rooms. So all the pilgrimages that are going to take place up to the 20th of July, if you come together to ask questions that you have. And at the same time, you could also delegate somebody to go to the workshops. These workshops are going to be about the Eucharistic procession, the Marian procession, and also you'll have seen on your program a workshop about families and children who come on pilgrimage and who are part of the hospitality. These will happen all around the Church of Saint Bernadette and the hemicycle, you'll have seen from your program. We haven't produced, you'll notice this year, booklets in paper form. The theme of the year that was written by Father Brito and Father Régis-Marie Latessonnière is available on the website. You'll have seen also that there are some catecheses on the theme of the year in little booklets. This is, if you like, an extension or a deepening of the theme of the year, and they're on sale in the bookshop. So you can find the text of the theme of the year on the website. But if you want to go into it even further, or perhaps even share it with your pilgrims in a slightly deeper form, then you can go and find the catecheses which are available, and they're available from the Grotto bookshop. I hope that's clear. So, Father Brito, Father of the Immaculate Conception, Chaplain of the Hospitality, Chaplain of the Sanctuary, welcome and thank you. Thank you, Matthias. Rector, brothers and sisters, all pilgrims. I'd like to give a talk, if you like, some instruction, more in form of a meditation, if you like. I'm going to try that we can learn amongst ourselves something about the pilgrimage, something about my own pilgrimage. You obviously are directors of pilgrimages, presidents of hospitalities. And so for us, the people who are people working in the sanctuary, it's something about we learn something about our own pilgrimage here as well, what we can do for you. We're going to talk a little bit about the words that the Virgin used when she asked Bernadette in Patois for people to come here in procession, on pilgrimage. And then a little bit of course about people who come here to Lourdes, because it's not only about people organized pilgrimages that come, but also singles, individuals, small groups, because of course everyone who comes here, we hope everyone leaves as a pilgrimage. When did the first pilgrimage start? Well, one day we left paradise. We are all on pilgrimage because of that. Since then, we've all been in search of our Father's house. We say, like the prodigal son, yes, I will go back to my Father's house. This is the pilgrimage of humanity. So we say we're all on pilgrimage, and it has a dimension of conversion, an aspect of conversion. We walk in very different ways, but we all have the same goal, a very distinct goal. And why? Because there's one element which is very important in our spiritual lives, with our relationship with God. And this element is, I would say, a gift of the Holy Spirit. And we would call this the nostalgia of God. It's a great Greek word, the nostalgie. Nostos, retour. Nostalgie, the pain of the country. Nostos, returning. All of our life, we are all in pilgrimage. We are all searching. In the book of the Apocalypse, in the letter to the church of
Saint John,
Saint John says, we all pass through great tests, and this great test is life. And this is given to each one of us personally, a small white stone, where everyone can read their own name, a small white pebble on which is engraved each person's name. The Bible also talks about black pebbles. These are symbols of the pain, the wounds that we carry. But each of us is given a small white pebble on which is engraved our name. And on this day, here I will be revealed to me who I am to God. This is like a symbol. We don't necessarily always know who we are. We're all searching for our identity in the eyes of God. This sanctuary of Lourdes is a huge grace, because in the person of Mary, the Immaculate Conception, as Father Dominican said, the Immaculate Conception is the heart of the being. In Mary, we contemplate and reflect on ourselves. We're all on the journey towards conversion. And in the Immaculate Virgin, we can see the perfection of humanity. This is the nostalgia of God. And when we see this, we want just one thing, but to die in the grace of God and to be able to see God. Why do we take this particular approach of coming on pilgrimage then? Well, it's very important for us as pilgrims, and in particularly for pilgrims here to Lourdes. So I'll say again, we are responsible for this. We are all responsible. And I will say even myself. First of all, we come to Lourdes to fulfill something, to fulfill the wishes of Our Lady. This is why we come. Why also then for the pilgrims? Why do pilgrims want to come on pilgrimage? Why do we place importance on the pilgrimage? Because for pilgrims, a pilgrimage is a question of life or death. It's a question of healing, a pardon, forgiveness that we've asked for, perhaps, the grace, a thank you for those people who have entrusted their intentions to you. It is of the highest importance. They've entrusted their intentions to you, and for them it's a question of life or death. But why do we come to sanctuaries, this sanctuary or others? Because the grace has preceded us. We know that here in Lourdes there is a grace. Mary draws her children to her. The first pilgrimage, I would say, was the women who went to see to the went to speak to the apostles to say that Jesus is risen. We see in the Gospel of John that they met in front of the empty tomb. Grace had preceded them because Jesus had risen. And therefore, they believed. If the grace of Mary wasn't in this grotto, we wouldn't come here. The grace perhaps can be an apparition. It might be a healing. On the 11th of February, there were 350 people here to see Bernadette experience the apparition. It might for some people be the discovery of a little statue. People might see in the church God's mercy. And the other aspect that seems important to me, when a pilgrim talks about making a pilgrimage, what's in their mind? What's gone before? Of course, one thinks of Lourdes and what happens in this place. This is where the place where we make the pilgrimage to. But we also can talk about the process during the pilgrimage that the pilgrim completes. The word pilgrimage also speaks to us about the group of people who come. Where is the pilgrimage? The pilgrimage is in a certain place. So we talk about the people who make up the pilgrimage group. I'm a pilgrim. Why? Because I'm making a pilgrimage in my own way. This is really important. What's our reference point when we're talking about pilgrimage? Is it the place, the people, or the approach that we take? First of all, a few important things to help you interpret the text that you might have seen on the internet. You might want to read, reread, meditate on it, reflect it, have meetings about it, to just find out what it is about, discover. Half of it or part of it was written by Father Régis Marie de la Tessonnière. It was at the invitation of the rector that the two of us came together to construct this text. So a few key important parts. This sanctuary of Lourdes, I might be wrong, but for me it's the only sanctuary that's benefited from an encyclical by the Pope Pius II. In this encyclical, in the month of July 1957, there was a section that was called the Pilgrimage to Lourdes. What we do here, is unique to the world. You don't find it in any other place. What we experience here is unique. So Lourdes has something very important to say to us about pilgrimage and pilgrimages. So Pope Pius XII, why does said talked about why pilgrimage exists? What's the point of pilgrimage? Because that's the goal of the sanctuary, the point of the sanctuary. To restore the world in Christ to restore the world in Christ by a new and incomparable effusion of the mystery of the redemption. That makes me tingle. So it's our responsibility that this grace, this effusion, can be part of the welcome, the reception that we give people here. We are the mediators of this experience. The sanctuary of Lourdes is a mediation. Mary is the mediatrix of all graces and blessings. She shows us her Son, the Christ, who in turn shows us the Father. And you and I are all part of this mediation between pilgrims and Christ. And the Pope continues. And our father, the rector here, has also made this connection between Pius X and the Eucharist. You'll already know that from our great basilica, the father of the Eucharist. He noted this link between the cult of the Eucharist, the worship during the Eucharist, and Mary, the mediation of Mary. The unique part of the sanctuary of Lourdes resides in the fact that people are drawn by Mary to a relationship with Christ in the Holy Sacraments. In that this sanctuary, this one here, without through the mediation of Mary, brings people to the Eucharist from all places in the Catholic world. And all these people, the sanctuary of Lourdes, seems to surpass through Mary and the Eucharist, surpass all the glory of all other sanctuaries in the world. So what I think to myself is, what does that mean to us? Well, for me, it's not particularly difficult. Because when Jesus left this world, He gave us three gifts. Maundy Thursday, He gave us the Eucharist. Good Friday, He gave us His Mother, the Immaculate, at the foot of the cross. This is your Mother. This is your Son. And from that time on, the disciple John took her into his home, and the day after, he gave us the Holy Spirit. the Eucharist, Mary, the Holy Spirit. The Eucharist, the only Paschal mystery, the death and the resurrection of Christ. The Eucharist gives us the Christ gives us his himself the sacramental in the sacrament. He gives us his life. Immaculate Mary, the second gift. The first and most precious fruit of the Paschal mystery. And as I said earlier on, and by reflecting on Mary, we reflect on our own humanity in the eyes of God. And we wish only to die and to be able to see God face to face, because we see ourselves in the person of Mary, saved through Christ. And then the gift of the Holy Spirit, the Church, the sanctuary. This morning, Father talked about the ecclesial dimension, the dimension of the Church. Pope Francis says in the sanctuary, pilgrims experience the maternal face of the Church. But after having seen Jesus, let's think about Bernadette. For Bernadette, the apparitions were first of all a pilgrimage that lasted for 3 months. So during the 18 apparitions, that from the first to last, about 3 months. And at the end of this great pilgrimage that Mary participated in, many people came to the grotto, and it was this experience of Bernadette that she was an experience that she shared with other people, her family, the authorities, obviously, people from Lourdes in the time, and at some point, and like, for example, on the 15th of August, I've seen thousands, tens of thousands of people coming to this grotto. So for Bernadette, the apparitions were her pilgrimage. But why? What for? Well, that's very straightforward. And this is also the goal of our pilgrimages. Bernadette was drawn by Mary to the grotto to grow in her humanity. And this is what pilgrimage is, an experience, a place where a pilgrim can grow in their humanity. This is what the Grotto of Lourdes talked to us about. This is what it speaks to us of. Second, to grow in our Christian life, because this is what Mary presented to Bernadette, the Paschal mystery, around the 12th apparition. Death, penitential gestures, the heart of this penitential gesture in the death of Christ was the discovery of the spring. And thirdly, to make Bernadette to grow in holiness, to grow in the heart of the Church. She went to see ask the priests to build a chapel here. And Bernadette said, first of all, where? Well, for Bernadette, it was first of all to build the church in her own community. And then, of course, for Bernadette, it was to build help build a community in Nevers. So, how did the apparitions finish for Bernadette? She made her first communion between the 17th and the 18th apparitions in 1858. She welcomed and received Christ in communion. Then, on the 18th apparition, Bernadette received the gift of Mary and the life of Mary. She was here, very close. She was on the opposite side of the Garve, if you remember. At the end of the apparition, she said, "I saw her looking more beautiful than I've ever seen her before. The gift of Mary." And it was this devotion she had for Mary and the life that she had with Mary that was most important to her. In the Montfort pilgrimage, we learn this devotion to Mary especially. And for John Paul II, it was hugely important as well. For Bernadette, at the end of the apparitions, she received interiorly the life of Mary. Well, why did Bernadette have those apparitions? Well, of course, to help her receive her first communion so that she could come to know God better. But another question for her: do you remember the little children of Mary? Do you remember that she was part of that little community? She wanted to be part of that group, and in order to do that, she had to make her first communion. So, 53 days after the final apparition, Bernadette was received into the Association of the Children of Mary, the Eucharist, Mary, and the Church. And so, how does the Sanctuary of Lourdes, through grace, how does it express all of this to the pilgrims? Easily, in a way, through the Eucharistic procession, through the torchlight Marian procession, and of course, the experience, the church experience of all our pilgrims. Are you still awake? Okay, well, I'll carry on for a bit then. The second part. The second part is an essentially pastoral part. What's the pastoral theme, if you like, of everything that we've talked about? I would start by a phrase of Pope Pius VI, I think, in his document. Which his encyclical title entitled The Announcement of the Gospel. He said, "The church exists for evangelization, and sanctuaries exist to evangelize. Pilgrimages exist to evangelize." Last year, how we talked about how do we evangelize. We gave letters and information, the catechesis. One of the chaplains of Lourdes last year, and you'll excuse me if I'm not going to give you his name, in one of these plenary sessions, if you like, said that vocation in Lourdes is that of showing people the grotto. The vocation of Lourdes is to show people the grotto. I've thought a lot about this phrase over the last few months, and I've come to a few conclusions. The first conclusion: gloire and honour of the Church of France, to glory and honour of the Universal Church. This is first and foremost the sanctuary of the Immaculate Conception. The sanctuary of Lourdes is a Marian sanctuary, not just any sanctuary, but the sanctuary of the Immaculate Conception. And the reality of this sanctuary of the Immaculate, I believe, means that we have three pastoral actions that are really important here for us and for each of the pilgrimages. Mary is the wife of the new alliance, because she carried in her womb the Saviour of the world. It was she who bore the alliance, the covenant within her. But how did Mary present this covenant to us, this covenant of God with us through the person of Jesus? In three ways. First of all, Mary, the wife of the covenant, the Immaculate Conception, presents us this mystery of proximity. This is what the Father spoke to us about this morning. And Mary presents us this mystery of proximity, certainly the mystery of the Incarnation, but here in Lourdes, this mystery was presented, yeah, that first of all by, of course, being here in Lourdes, but in terms of being at the foot of the cross, this mystery of being close, this mystery of proximity to Jesus. And while here in Lourdes, Mary made the sign of the cross, Bernadette also was able to make the sign of the cross. And her fear disappeared because the lady was close to her, was in proximity to her. And this proximity we also find in the Gospel, the Good Samaritan parable, you may remember. This poor man who was lying at the side of the road. And two people passed by, a priest and a Levite. The priest is our religion, and the Levite represents the law. The religion and law and the law passed him by and took no notice. And the third person was the stranger who stopped, a foreigner. Jesus posed this question, who is my neighbour? That's the person who is close to us. And it's this proximity that we see between Mary and Bernadette and between the Samaritan and the stranger, the foreigner. And it's shown to us through the application of oils when the man was looked after, he bathed his wounds. This is given to us in the symbol of oil. So for us in our pilgrimage is, I would call this the pastoral care of proximity, being close to people. We could also call it the pastoral care of being compassionate, of tenderness and of affection.
Quels sont les moyens?
What are the means through which we express or show this closeness to people? Through compassion, through tenderness, and through affection. For example,
de la tende, pastorale de la proximité, c'est bien sûr la pastorale de la miséricorde.
The pastoral care of being close to somebody is the pastoral care of mercy. What is Lourdes? Lourdes is the refuge of sinners. We say this in our litany. The Immaculate, she is the refuge of sinners. Do our pilgrimages also refuges for sinners? We're not just talking about the sick, but for everybody. Are they really a refuge for sinners? Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us, poor sinners. This is what Bernadette says. Pray for me, a poor sinner. So do we show this pastoral care of mercy in our pilgrimages? Secondly, I'm going to tell you three examples. The second is popular piety. How should we integrate something which escapes us all the time? Why do I say that this escapes us all the time? Well, quite simply, this popular piety helps us with a personal relationship with God, and that's sacred. And nobody invented the gestures of piety in here in Lourdes, to touch the rock, to have the water, to wash in the water, to light the candle. Do we talk about this? Do we integrate this into our pilgrimages? You know that we as priests bless all the candles, the bits that the pilgrims buy. But it's really important for us to be able to do that. And for the pilgrims, it's really important. This is pastoral care of proximity, by being close to people to do that. And these three gestures. If we have an heart open to Christ, then we show mercy to others. The rock, the gesture of rock, the rock which is God for us. And we see the light of Christ in the gesture of the candle gesture, the gesture of light. A third example, the pastoral care in tenderness and compassion and affection. You might remember the text Evangelii Gaudium from Pope Francis. Mary transformed the pigsty into a house of God. She transformed into a mountain of tenderness. And he continues, there is a Marian style in the church's evangelization, because each time we look at Mary, we believe in the revolutionary force of tenderness and compassion. The sanctuary, the pilgrimage, these are revolutionary places of grace, of the grace of tenderness and compassion. Every day, I am blown away by the tenderness, the compassion of our brothers and sisters in the hospitality. The second pastoral act, if you like, that we need to think about for our pilgrimages. When we contemplate the Immaculate, is what I would call in the person of the Immaculate, we contemplate the wife of the covenant, the mystery of the receptivity of the Word of God and the sacraments. I would say perhaps Mary was the one who was most receptive to the Word of God. Mary was the one who made the efforts to be open to the Word of God, to be open to the words of her son in the words of the scriptures, if you remember, in the wedding at Cana. She was the one who said, do whatever he tells you. And this is what Bernadette did. She did what Mary asked her to do. You remember at the wedding at Cana, they said, they have no more wine. If you remember, Jesus said, woman, what do you want me to do? Mary was receptive to her son, Jesus. She understood him. She said to the servants, do what he tells us, what he tells you. Father spoke to us this morning. The Word of God is not just what we hear in Mass every day, the Gospel, but it's in the catechesis, it's in the Mass, the celebrations, the homilies. It's the receptivity to the Word of God. The next part, the receptivity, being receptive to the sacraments in our pilgrimages. Obviously, there are the three great sacraments in the pilgrimage: the anointing of the sick, communion, obviously. But reconciliation, but are all these three a big part of our pilgrimages? The divinity of God, this essential part of our pilgrimage. I'm not criticizing, it's just something I'm thinking about, these reconciliation services that I see, which are massively long. And the pilgrims are here simply because they need a priest to pardon their sins. Do we enable them to receive these sacraments in the best way possible? And the third part, I would say, is the pastoral care of discovery and integration into the church community. This is part of the integration that pilgrimage directors and hospitality presidents and their teams must talk to each other at the service, so as to be at the service of your pilgrims. Young people, adults with young people. Of course, there are different cultures. There are many, many cultures that come here in different to Lourdes, but how do we integrate them? We don't all speak the same language. But the most important is we are here to serve others. Maybe we come here with other ideas that are more important, to be seen, to be heard, perhaps. But for us, it's about integration, the pastoral care of integrating. How do we integrate our pilgrimage with other pilgrimage who are here? The other element, this Mary as the wife of the covenant, I would say, is fruitfulness. What does that mean, fruitfulness? In the church language, in public language, in everyday language, in Mary we contemplate virgin and mother. I would begin by saying I get down on my knees in front of the virginity of Mary. And the word virgin also means, in the biblical language, that which carries a treasure. And if we have a treasure, this is something that is given to us. Mary is a virgin in both physical and spiritual sense because she houses the Word of God in Jesus. And the sanctuary is where the grace of Lourdes can be found. It doesn't keep it for itself. It shares it and gives it to us. The sanctuary houses the graces of Lourdes. And it shares them with you. This is a very simple question. Who spoke to you about Lourdes for the very first time in your life? From who did you learn about Lourdes first? For this person was Mary, virgin and mother. This is the mystery of evangelization, or one of the mysteries of evangelization. We're the holders of a treasure, but we need to then give this treasure. This is what fruitfulness means. We are the fruitfulness. We are the fruit of this fruitfulness. All the other Lourdes sanctuaries that have grown up throughout the world is because there are missionaries who've been out to spread the word of Lourdes, who've spread the word of what happens here. We are holders of this treasure, and it has been shared with other people throughout the world. The most important, for example, is the pastoral action of communication, of passing the message on. What does that mean? So what are we communicating? And how? What is the hierarchy of communication? The second thing, if you remember, Mary took the treasure to Elizabeth. She departed in haste, if you remember. She didn't say, oh, I'll go tomorrow, I'll go next week. No, she departed in haste. So our next pastoral action is that of acting in good time. And then it's about a commitment. Hospitality make a commitment. It's not up to the president to ask them, is that something that you want to do now? Are you okay with that? The hospitality make a commitment to be there and make their service. The third, of course, is the pastoral action of being a missionary and passing on the message of Lourdes, to discover the maternal face of the church. To find the face of church that I want to serve, that I want to love, that I want to share with others. This is a real experience that pilgrims enter into, this an eminently personal journey where they grow in humanity, where they grow in Christian life, and they grow in holiness. I want to finish with a few words. Two books. First, that which Father Regis Marie de la Thiessonnière, Lourdes in Procession. A few years ago, he wrote this. Just a little treasury, if you like. And I don't want to repeat what's in the book, but the Grotto, A Way of the Gospel, also by Father Régis Marie La Tessonnière. Thank you very much indeed for listening.
Je vous remercie, Père Brito, pour cet enseignement.
Thank you very much, Father Brito, for this talk. A few tips. The CD of the theme of the year is also available, as well as the catechesis. The CD of the music for this year will be available on the in the 15th of March, but you can buy it in advance if you wish. If you want to go to the orientation village, it's available, and also in the bookshop from the 15th of March. But I'm going to let you go now for the planning meeting for pilgrimage is up to the 20th of July, and for the workshops for other people if you wish. At the same time, the workshops in this church and in the hemicycle. Have a look at your program. Two workshops on processions, and then a workshop which will focus particularly in welcoming families and children into the hospitalities. We'll meet here again for a plenary at 5 o'clock.